Kevin Ferry has a book out called The Haunted Truth.
You know that somebody near Alicia?
You have to call. Sorry, I'm at work. Yeah. The Haunted Truth is about a young lady who goes through things in life. She has been a rape victim. She was murdered. She was a exotic dancer. She became a mom. Yeah. Right. Awesome. How he put the book, because she was a young lady that loved men that was older than her, and she loved fashion, and she loved the bling bling, and she loved the hot top face. You know, this is back in 1988. Give me the bling bling, the man with the drive, you know, the man with the ride, the man with the nice haircut, and a good big bling bling on his chest. Little muscles. Yeah, give me him. When I was about her age, I thought the same. Give me the man with the car. And I got the money. You know, give me the hustler. I want the hustler. That's what she was into. She was into the ballers. She had a tragic life, like. I am learning from this book how not to trust everyone around my daughter or my male sons. No matter how old they are, definitely as babies, you can't trust everybody around children. When you first get a boyfriend, you don't incidentally introduce your children to them. You gotta make sure that you and that individual is really gonna be together. Like, how many years it's gonna take for this man to see my children, or how many months is it gonna take for me to introduce my children, right, to this man? Am I going to show this man to my mom or my dad, or am I going to introduce him as a friend, or am I going to introduce him as my man? First thing first, background checks is a must. I have to do a background check on you. I need to know, what kind of criminal are you? If you don't have a record, then okay. But you still have some things that I have to scope out. Your attitude. The way you treat others. Are you lovable? Are you understanding? Things like that. I had a boyfriend, you know, came home from jail. Just like this young lady's mom came home from jail. You know, her boyfriend came home from jail. He stayed with her. But the question is why he went to jail. What was he in jail for? In the process of him being in jail, how long was he locked up? What things was he doing inside the jailhouse that made him want to touch someone younger than him? You sleep with my mother every day. My mother not good enough for you? Wow. It's amazing how these babies, now so many babies are being molested nowadays that it hurts. Why are you abusing someone that can't defend themselves? Yeah, but back to the haunted truth is, the young lady, she lived in the projects. She grew up in the projects with her mom, and I believe it was her brother, her mom and her brother. She had a crush on this young man. Young man had a crush on her as well. They started seeing each other. Constantly seeing each other on the back stairwell, giving each other kisses, whatever. End up intimate. The mother's boyfriend finds out. And he starts sexually abusing her. Somewhat hard to talk about this book because I've been here. I was sexually abused. I was an exotic dancer. Love men older than me. Should have been, could have been dead a long time ago. Some of us get out of it. Some of us can't. Some of us are still holding on to the abuse that we went through in our past. Some of us won't even talk about it. We won't talk about it because it hurts to talk about it. We won't confront it. Like, I have back my first time confronting my issues that stopped me from loving myself. How can I love someone like me who has so much bitterness, hatred, envy, strife against men? I was like her. I loved men that was older than me. I dealt with hustlers. They had the money. I was raped as well. So, you know, the book really touched me. I just need y'all to go and follow Mr. Kevin. Mr. Kevin. I can't pronounce his last name. But yeah, go follow him. He's on my page. You will see him. He always has his logo up. And he does things on live all the time. So I need y'all to go and see him. And I'm going to pin this. I need y'all to go see him. He is awesome. Awesome writer. Awesome. Very awesome. And now I am reading New Shoes. Wow. Do I love myself more than my shoes? I'm not going to start talking about that one yet, but yeah, I do. I do love myself more than my shoes, but I take care of my shoes as well because shoes cost money. But yeah, I love myself more than my shoes. I had to learn how to love myself more than my shoes because of the hurt that I've been through. But I do love myself more than my shoes now. Before I didn't, but now I do. So I want y'all to go, and I just pinned his website on here. I need y'all to go and check out his books. They are awesome. Thank y'all for listening. Now I'm going to get back to work.